This is Palm Beach Live Work Play. I'm Tim Bird, the Birdman, and today we're at the Palm Beach Sheriff's Office with Sheriff Rick Bradshaw. And today is kind of our second installment, Sheriff. We talked about many things the last time we were together. It was actually enough for three full segments, and people have seen that and commented that they really, really enjoyed those. But today, I wanted to, you touched on the last time we spoke, all the many different areas that you're responsible for protecting and taking care of in Palm Beach County. And the thought is, oh, gee, there they are in their cruisers, and that's the extent. Oh, it's way, way more than that. So I'll just hand it to you and let you start telling us all the different areas that you are responsible for protecting.
Of course, first and foremost is Road Patrol, because that's where we answer normal calls for service, and that is the largest part of the organization, which is Road Patrol handling the neighborhoods and handling when people call in. But the second largest thing that we do is corrections. We operate three jails. The main jail is on Gun Club Road. We have one in the central part of the county behind the fairgrounds. And then there's another one in the western part of the communities, which is actually a brand new jail that was just built. Our average daily population is pretty close to 3,000 people.
In each jail?
No, totally.
Oh, totally, okay.
Totally, yeah. But that's a large population. That means 9,000 meals a day. That means you have to transport them to court. That means you have to take care of their medical expenses. So that's a huge part of what we do. Now, also, we have to make sure that we protect the airport. Even though you go through the airport and there's the TSA people that screen you, the actual security of the airport is the responsibility of the sheriff.
Now, just so I can make sure we're clear, TSA is a federal thing?
TSA is the federal screeners that right. You see when you go through there, and they check your luggage and they screen you through the system. Yes. Although we have to respond to any of the problems they have there, because they don't really have powers of arrest unless it's a federal violation. So we are basically the security at the airport above and beyond them. The waterways, the intercoastal waterways, Lake Okeechobee, and in fact our jurisdiction goes all the way to the Bahamas, because we work with the Immigration and Customs Enforcement and the Coast Guard.
Now that can get a little touchy, being a peninsula like Florida is, sticking way out and surrounded by water. We have to really be aware of everything that's going on around us at all times, I suppose.
Yeah, well, basically, that's our border. Yeah. You know, you hear about the border problem that they have on the border with Mexico. This is our border out here. So we have to pay a lot of attention to what's coming on with illegal aliens and other people that may want to come in here and hurt us.
Right.
So that's another part of the operation. All the courthouses, all of the security at the courthouses, not only inside the courtrooms for protection for the judges, but the courthouse security is the responsibility of the sheriff. Of course, we have our aviation unit that patrols the air spaces that are our responsibility up to 1,000 feet in the air. We serve all of the warrants and all of the evictions. Unfortunately, in today's environment, there's more evictions that we'd like to have, on foreclosures. But also the warrant sections, all the warrants that need to be served, the people that don't show up for court, or our fugitive section for people that are wanted on serious felonies that go out and find them. So there's a lot of ancillary units that are here, our crime scene people. We have a regional crime lab which analyzes all of the DNA that's submitted to us and narcotics that are going to go to court. So it's a large operation.
I guess, is SWAT included in that as well?
Well, that's one of the major functions on the road when we have hostage situations or barricaded armed suspects that we're going to go take care of it with the SWAT people. They also are involved in our high liability or high warrant services for people that are wanted on felony warrants.
I got to tell you, Sheriff, that's an amazing thing. And when you have to start dealing with a budget, of course, there's land, air, equestrian. There's so many things that you take care of on top of what is just plainly visible to the daily citizen on a daily basis, I should say. It's an amazing, mind-boggling thing for me. And to manage that, run it as well as you do, our hats off to you.
The budget in itself, people always hear how large the sheriff's department budget is. It's large because you have a large organization with 4,000 employees, but just to operate the jail is $140 million a year. 9,000 meals a day is basically what you're serving, and you have to take care of their medical expenses, because all the people that come to us are not necessarily in the best of health. They have mental issues, obviously, or they wouldn't be with us. And we have to transport them and secure them. So that's a large operation, and you don't have the luxury of just telling somebody, would you send 500 people home today and have them check in next week? They're yours. And everybody that gets arrested in this county comes to the county jail.
Well, it's a huge job. It's a man-sized job, and we're lucky to have you. Thank you for your time today. It's always good to shed some light on things that not everybody is totally aware of, and I really learned a lot just listening to this conversation today. We appreciate you, and thank you so much for your time today, Sheriff Bradshaw.
Thank you for being here.
Tim Bird, the Birdman, and that wraps up another conversation up close and personal with Sheriff Bradshaw. Stay tuned next month, and we'll have another up close episode for you to watch. Thank you so much for watching.